Welcome to Unit 7.4. In this unit, we will classify the underlying net of HKUST-1. This means we want to obtain the coordination sequence and the vertex symbol for this net. If you have accidentally closed the simplified net of HKUST-1, click Open. Go to your HKUST-1 directory and open the file with the name HKUST-1_C. C stands for child. Topos uses a so-called TTD collection as a database to classify nets. They are based on projects that collect topological data that has either been discovered or calculated. You can find links to some of these projects in the References and Resources tab. Before we start, please make sure that these files are loaded. Go to Database, TTD Collection, and then click Reload. This may take some time. Once this process is finished, we are ready to go. Select the simplified net of HKUST-1 and run the ADS program by clicking this button. Another window opens. Click Options. In the Commons tab, make sure that this option is switched off. Save simplified net. We have already simplified the net. Now it is time to classify. In the Topology tab, mark the following options: point symbols and classification. The other three tabs, tiling, molecular VDP, and continuous, can be left at their default settings. Click OK to save and close the options. Click Run. Another small window opens. Right-click on the table and choose Select All. Then click OK. The classification of the underlying net is now produced in this window. We see, for example, the coordination sequences for each of the nodes. For the 3 connected node, the organic SBU, the coordination sequence is 3, 9, 15, 33, and so on. And for the 4 connected node, the copper pedal wheel, the coordination sequence is 4, 8, 20, 30, 60, and so on. Of course, vertex symbols are given for both nodes. And Topos also tells us that this net has been found in the so-called RCSR database. It has a 3-letter code, TBO. In this case, it is derived from an existing crystal structure, namely twisted borosite. You can find a link to this database in the References and Resources tab. With this 3-letter code, we can search for this net in the RCSR database to obtain further information. There is, for example, a literature reference for this net, and there is a pretty picture. But this does not look like a net. This is a 3-dimensional tiling for this net. We will talk about tilings in the next unit.